Lingus Publications, Broken TV is proud to introduce to you Strivers Row, the TV show. I'm your host, Sean Hicks. Thank you all for watching, whether it's via the internet or whether it's through TV. I appreciate everyone for giving a watch here. Let me describe who I am first so that you don't, you know, think you're just wasting your time with someone just in front of the camera. I am a publisher. I am an author. I am someone out here on the grind trying to get to the next level, like so many of you. You have talent, you have skill, you have ambition, you have desire to have your dreams fulfilled, but you may not necessarily know how to get from one level to the other. That's what this show is about. This show is about promoting the independent artists, promoting independent authors, promoting independent works in general. No disrespect for all of those who got nice contracts and signed with the nice labels and with the nice publishing groups. But most of the time, it's pretty much a grind to even get to that level. So when you have belief in yourself, you got to put your money where your mouth is. You have to make everything manifest, and you have to get out here on this grind called the streets. You know, that's why you see a lot of people out here in New York selling their books hand-to-hand, selling their CDs hand-to-hand, showing their artwork hand-to-hand, you know. And how to get from that point to the next point is what the show is about. Striving for the next level. That's why it's called Strivers Row. It's the first interview that I did a little few months ago. Author Gary Haywood, he created a book called Corruption Officer. You're going to hear me interview him. You're going to hear his story. It's going to be riveting. It's going to be exciting. And stay tuned for Strivers Row, the TV show.
Then you don't have to keep coming every visit to bring him money because he's juggling juggling is when inmates trade and they switch and they, you know, get commissary and stuff like that. So off that one little part of tobacco, you don't have to bring on commissary for about 2 or 3 months. And all it cost you was maybe $100 for me. And he's making $200 or $300 over there, so it works out. It's like, I got paid for my services, and you helped you out, so you don't have to spend a lot of money. I mean, I hate to say it, but that's the way it is.
It wasn't just tobacco.
Oh no.
Marijuana.
Okay, I'm gonna tell you what happened with me. Nervous Ned, that's me. You know, I started, well, basically, I got back in jail. Like I said, I had a situation where I was going through divorce itself. That don't legitimize what I did. That don't make it right at all. But when my back was against the wall, I started to help out. So now, I started out with cigarettes. Smoking in here, okay, if I got cigarettes, you roll the pain, okay, I take the money.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So, gradually, it was just cigarettes, but I'm not going to say no name. I'm never going to put another correction officer in my circle saying they did what I did. But it makes talk.
Okay.
And here I am, I'm doing cigarettes, but somebody across the street is doing cocaine.
Okay.
Is doing weed. And they tripling and doubling the amount of money that I'm making with these little cigarettes. It's just like the street. If I got nickel bags on this corner and you selling something, if my nickel bags are fatter than your dime, all the customers gonna come to me. So when you say it wasn't just cigarettes, over a period of time, as I got bolder and got more comfortable and felt that, you know, that I wasn't gonna get caught, I wasn't gonna say I'm gonna touch you, I started doing, you know, heavy drugs. Not doing, but I started selling heavy drugs. Cocaine, weed, tobacco, you know, anything. Put it like this. At one time, it was like however you want. If it was your birthday, you wanted to drink, $500, I'll bring you half a pint of this. You know what I'm saying? It's not every day because there's that rule of the regulations that I have to go by. I can't have you running around the jail drunk. You know what I'm saying? But even though you being high with cocaine is a danger to everyone else as well, in my mind frame at the time, I wasn't thinking about the jail, I wasn't thinking about other officers, I wasn't thinking about nothing. I was thinking about getting that money, doing what I had to make sure my back wasn't up against the wall.